Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to LEGO Weaponry. Now, today, as you may realise, I am wearing the same clothing from the last episode. That is because I have recorded this episode, straight after the episode I've done before, if that makes any sense. Anyway, let's just ignore it and let's just talk about today's episode. Now, today, I have made a musket loading rifle that has been ever made first thing for the channel. So really, what that means, this is my first time that I've made a musket loading gun ever. So yes, this might be new for me and all, so yes, it might be a little bit rusty, but either way, let's just show you this good old shotgun, shall we? Now, you probably already know what shotgun I'm on about, but either way, here it is, as you may tell from the big trumpet-shaped muzzle here. Oh yes, it is a blunderbuss. Oh yes, just good old blunderbuss. Now, I don't know who is the inventor of this blunderbuss, but either way, hopefully the facts will let us know anyway. Either way, I'm quite curious on the history and the comparisons of this particular shotgun. So, we shall have a look, shall we? Interesting. Right, let's show you the areas and the features of this shotgun. First things first is, yes, the stock is the same from my previous weapons that have the same stock. Well, what I'm planning to do is making weapons that have the same shaped stock, then as soon as I've done those, I'll be moving on to other weapons that have a different shaped stock on it. So yeah, that's my plans for the time being, but either way, let's move on. Right, here's the moving trigger. Trigger guard. And now, I don't know what this part or this part is called. That's because I'm not that much of a musket expert, but hopefully you guys understand either way. Anyway, let's move on. This part here. Now, all I know what this does is, well, when you put your gunpowder and your projectiles in, you get this and you make them go all the way down to the bottom of the barrel. So that, hang on, let me just put this back. So that the gunpowder and the projectiles end up here at the back, like so. And when you load this up, well, let me show you a demonstration. When you load it up, that goes like that. A spark goes, well, is made, and that goes through the hole that is here. I don't know if you could see that. Yeah, it goes through that hole. And that goes to the, it makes contact with the gunpowder, ignites that, and makes a small explosion, which is enough to push out the projectiles out of the gun. So yes. And the reason why there's no sights on this shotgun, that's because the projectiles spread. It's not that accurate. It goes all over the target instead of just concentrating on one area, not like a rifle musket. This is designed for spread use, really. It's like, you want to be 100% that you get the target, so yeah, not be like finicky about it. But either way, hope you guys enjoyed this good old episode. Don't forget to leave a like or a comment down below on what you think of this episode. It should really help me a lot. But if you really liked it, why not subscribe to my channel and keep the channel going? It should really help me a lot as well. Oh yes, good old channel stuff. And keep up to date with videos that I do. Oh yes, feel free. And check out the links in the description below. They are homepages to my Facebook, Instagram, Twitch, Twitter, Tumblr, Google+, and all that crud. So yes, feel free to check those out. All I do is like posts and messages based around the channel, like videos and all that stuff. Videos that I share to the public and all that, so I could spread the word and all that stuff. But either way, hope you can help out by spreading the word too. Oh yes, help me out a little bit with that. And as always, well, there's one thing I'd like to say. On Thursday, I'll be making another musket, but this time's a lot smaller in comparison, which is bound to be a musket pistol. But thing is, I don't know which pistol I'll be making, so I'll probably figure out which one. within the days that are going through until Thursday, that is. So make sure you aren't there on Thursday. That's if I, that's if I end up with something in my mind. So yes, feel free to check out on Thursday if I make one, that is. Either way, hope you guys enjoyed this good old episode. And as always, enjoy the rest of your days. Salutes!